Are you all happy today? Okay, very good. Students, in our last class, what did we learn? We learned about the negative impacts of smartphones. Negative impacts of smartphone usage. What is the title of the lesson? Smartphones, addiction and games. What is the title? Smartphones, addiction and games. Here, Abhir Roy is explaining about the negative impacts or the disadvantages these smartphones created in this world. Nowadays, everywhere we could see people are busy with their mobile phones. They are not spending time with their family members, but they are always busy with their smartphones. It is not good for our health. It is not good for our eyes, brain, our spinal cord, our neck. Okay, psychologically people are affected because of the over usage of smartphone. And nomophobia is one of the new term coined. Without mobile phone, human cannot survive. Okay, and also he explains about one of the incidents, one of the real life incidents happened in the life of Rose. This Rose is confessing that once he was addicted to mobile phone and he cannot do any other works other than using the smartphone. He cannot read the newspaper, he cannot watch a full movie, and finally he uninstalled all the unnecessary apps, but still he cannot overcome that problem. And now this is what we have seen in our last class. Now let's see. Paul Axley is a cognitive psychologist. What is meant by cognitive? It deals with the processing of information gathered in our human brains. So cognitive is always related to knowledge, related to our brain. Okay. Here, this psychologist Paul Axley is saying that people are social organisms. Okay. Who are social organisms? We people. Human beings are the social organism and we are stimulated with our mobile phone. What does it mean by stimulus? Stimulus means something which will produce a reaction. It is the reason for some reaction. For example, for stimulus, I will tell you an example. Okay. Now I am scolding you and what is the result? You will cry. Okay. So for crying, my scolding is the reason. Okay. I am scolding you, that's why you are crying. So this is the stimulus. It is creating some reaction. So the sound in the mobile phone is the stimulus and automatically it enters into our brain and we are thinking that, okay, I have to check my mobile phone. So people are completely addicted to this mobile phone. Whenever I hear a bell sound or ringtone in my mobile phone, automatically my brain will say that take your mobile phone and check the messages. Okay, this is what said by Paul Axley. He is a cognitive psychologist. Cognitive, it is related to brain functioning. Okay, how information are gathered and stored in our brain. Alright students, okay. Next, Earl Miller, he is a neuroscientist and he is saying that the overusage of smartphone is declining the brain function. At a time, can we do two works? No. While speaking, can I write? While writing, can I speak? While cooking, can I do any other works? No. Our brain can do one work at a time. But what we are doing, we'll keep our mobile phone aside and we'll do some works. In the meantime, somebody will call or we'll check the WhatsApp messages or we'll check our emails. So, what's happening? concentrating in two things, but Earl Miller is saying that we cannot concentrate in two works. If you are doing a serious work, if you are doing your project, or if you are doing an assignment, or if you are doing any serious work, in the meantime, if you are checking your mobile phones also, what will happen? Your brain will stuck from this and you are taking the concentration to this mobile phone and you cannot come back to your work. At once or within a second, you cannot shift the concentration from your work and from your emails. Okay, while doing your work, you are checking your emails or you are checking your WhatsApp messages. Then your brain will stuck in between. You cannot come back to the full concentration to do your works. Do you need concentration to do your works? Yes, of course. Even if it is a simple work, you need full concentration to complete that work. But Earl Miller is saying, because of the over usage of smartphones, people are not concentrating in anything. If they are doing any project or if they are doing any work, in between they are checking their mobile phone and their brain is shifted from one place to another. And to take it back to the first work, it's very difficult. It's very difficult to take our concentration from the second to the first. All of a sudden, it will not come back. Okay, it takes more time. So this is what said by Earl Miller. He is a neuroscientist. Our National Institute of Health is saying that because of the overusage of smartphone, people are suffering and there are so many health issues related to the overusage of smartphone. It is not good for our brain. As I told you already, it is not good for our brain, our eyes, or neck. Here they are saying that people, while using their smartphone, they are bending their neck to 60 degrees. Okay, we are bending our neck and also we are giving more effort to this place. So it is not good for our neck. And so many other psychological problems also we need to face, like depression, anxiety. We are uploading so many videos. We are posting in Facebook, in Twitter, and it creates some anxiety, some nervousness, fear, and also it is creating depression in the mind of the people. So this is what said by the National Institute of Health. Okay. Now, Abhay Roy is concluding this essay by giving some suggestions how to control the overusage of smartphone. How to control? Can you guess? Already I told you that try to switch off your mobile phone for one whole day. Did you do that? Okay. So Abhay Roy is concluding his essay by telling that there are so many apps available and these apps will help us to control the mobile usage. And there are other scientists are advising or giving more suggestions. Instead of using your smartphones, you can spend more time with nature. So nature is the best friend for each and everybody in this world. Nature is the best friend. So you can give more time to spend with your family members. You can read books. Reading maketh a full man. So instead of wasting your time with your mobile phone, you can read books. You can spend time with your family members. You can sit in nature and you can look at the beauty of nature. So by these techniques, we can slowly reduce the overusage of smartphone. It's good for our health also. So thus, he concluded his essay, Smartphones, Addiction and Gaze. Is that clear, students? So this particular essay is all about the negative impacts. What are the negative impacts these smartphones are creating mentally and physically? All right?
Students, take your textbook, take page number 77. The addiction that Ruth is writing about has become a global phenomenon. According to Paul Atsley, a cognitive psychologist at the University of Kansas, the reason for our inability to sever our ties with our phones is because we are essentially social organisms. Paul Atsley is a cognitive psychologist. What is meant by cognitive? Branch of psychology that focuses on the way people process information. How we are processing information? We are processing information with our brain. He is working in the University of Kansas and he is saying that human beings are social organisms. This is why there's nothing more compelling than social information, which activates a part of our brain that is hardwired to respond to unique sights or sounds. As we are social organisms, we are activating our brain to respond to unique sights or unique sounds, like the ringtone or a bing sound in your mobile phone. When we hear the sound of a beep, buzz, or a ping from our phone, there's the implicit promise of new social information. It comes as a stimulus. So this ping sound or a buzz sound of your mobile phone is the stimulus, which not only can't be ignored, but is also so powerful that it will lure us away from whatever activity we may be engaged in. So, if you are working with something or if you are doing some works, whenever you hear this beep sound or a ping sound from your mobile phone, automatically you will stop that work and you will check your mobile phone. So, this ringtone is the stimulus to our brain and is saying that take your mobile phone and check the messages. According to many leading psychologists in the United States, heavy users of smartphones often cannot differentiate between various modes of communication. According to Earl Miller, professor of neuroscience at MIT, when we are working and using our phones, simultaneously we get distracted, and that prevents us from thinking deeply on the project we are working on. What Earl Miller is saying? Earl Miller is saying that when we are working and using our phone simultaneously, at the same time, if you are working and also using a mobile phone, what will happen? Our concentration will distract and it will prevent us from thinking deeply on the work we are doing. We cannot give full concentration towards the work we are doing. Although we may think that we will be able to check a text or email very quickly and get back to whatever we are doing, we really can't. And we are saying that often we are checking the emails or text and then we are continuing the work. But human brain cannot switch from one to another. Professor Miller says, every time you switch your focus from one thing to another, there's something called a switch cost. Your brain stumbles a bit and it requires time to get back to where it was before it was distracted. So he is saying that nobody can do two works, like doing a work and using the mobile phone. Our concentration will distract. This is the message in this paragraph. Next, the worst thing is if we are used to checking our device every few minutes, we may even become susceptible to what is called a phantom text syndrome. When we think we hear a text or alert, but there isn't one. So it is called phantom text syndrome. There will be no message coming in your mobile phone, but still you are checking your mobile phone often. Those of us who think that we cannot disconnect ourselves from our smartphones need to know that technology does make us less effective workers. Overuse of smartphones also leads to several health issues. While one major study, which was funded by the National Institutes of Health, associated high social media usage to depression, other research findings indicate that social networking with our smartphones has a very high chance of increasing our anxiety. What is the meaning of anxiety? Nervousness. Anxiety level, both about how we compare with other people and about being removed from these devices. Additionally, there are dangers of walking into traffic as one checks her or his messages. It is very dangerous, right? While walking on the road, if you are using a smartphone, if you are checking the messages, what will happen? Automatically? Yes. There is also a new health problem due to our virtual codependency called tech neck, which can affect many of us since we tilt our heads forward 60 degrees to peer at our phones. What we are doing? We are looking into the mobile phone screen by bending our head and neck to 60 degrees. Then 60 degrees to peer at our phones, putting about 60 pounds of pressure on our neck. There's also vision fatigue and headaches along with insomnia. You know what is insomnia, right? So there's also vision fatigue. What does it mean by fatigue? Tiredness and headaches along with insomnia, which is very common among heavy users of smartphones. So, what's the antidote for the problems associated with our smartphones? Now, there are mobile apps that will help us monitor how much time we are spending on the phone each day. So, these mobile apps will help us to reveal how much time we are spending on the mobile phone every day. Digital wellness is a budding industry these days, with loads of self-help gurus offering miracle cures for screen addiction. Digital wellness is also a company which is helping people to cure for screen addiction. Some of those solutions involve new devices such as the light phone, a device with an extremely limited feature set that is meant to wean users off time-sucking apps. There are also many self-help books written by experts who offer their advice as to how to take a break from our phones. The authors of these self-help books urge us to spend more time in nature. First is, we should spend more time in nature, which may counteract the focus draining effects of too much time spent on looking at our phones. Other experts recommend that we put our phone on silent mode and to set our email to deliver new messages only every 30 minutes. We can change the settings in our mobile phone. Not often or not every minute. We can receive new messages only every 30 minutes or 1 hour. Digital Sabbath has become quite popular in the West among many heavy users of smartphones, where the users give their devices a rest for 24 hours over a weekend. What these people are doing? They'll give rest to their mobile phone for 1 day by the weekend. Finally, experts exhort us not to carry our phones everywhere we go. The self-help gurus who offer cures for our smartphone addiction are unanimous in their advice. Don't be a slave to your smartphone. What is the message? Don't be a slave to your smartphone. While it's true that our smartphones have helped us get connected with the whole world and have made our lives easier and more social in important ways, we also seem to have less genuine connections with people in our everyday life. Of course, smartphones are helping in so many ways, but still, there are defects. We are having fewer quality conversation based on physical presence. Always we are talking with our family members through mobile phone, not physically. Physical presence is very important. As we have become more technologically savvy, we also seem to have lost our ability to live in the present. We forget to live in the present, where we can engage in genuine one-on-one communication. The question is, he wind up the essay by asking two questions. Do we want to live an I life or a real life? Do we give more attention to a 5-inch piece of hardware with no pulse than we give to humans? We are giving more attention to the 5-inch hardware piece. It has no pulse. We are giving more attention to this object, but we are not giving attention to human beings. Thus, he end the lesson, smartphones addiction at gaze. Students, do you understand?
Students, I hope you all have understood our today's class. See you all in the next class, students. Until then.